Welcome to this edition of the Dean's Video Newsletter. Today we're going to talk about a very specific item, and this is really very, very specific to our researchers and the milieu in which we're working in right now. This is probably the most difficult period of time that we've seen since I've been a researcher, so that's some 20-odd years, where we're seeing a real fundamental change in how funding is provided to support our research enterprise. The CIHR, so the Canadian Institutes for Health Research, is undergoing a significant change this year as we look at foundation grants, a change in the way the operations grants are coming forward, and a lot of the initiatives that are embedded with that. We have programs across the country which are demanding that there be significant matching dollars come forward to assist with them, and if not present, our investigators can't participate in that. So all in all, it's a very, very difficult milieu. So what are we as a school doing to try and help you with that and to help advance the school's initiatives? And I can tell you that I've had any number of investigators, colleagues like myself who are busy in the lab, coming and saying, I'm worried about my lab, I'm worried about my ability to keep the facility going or to have the individuals stay within it because I don't have the resources. And honestly, it would be wonderful if I could provide resources to every single individual to carry through this time period. I can't. We simply don't have that amount of funding at hand. So how are we going to do this? Well, we're going to partner on many different fronts. So first, right off the top, we'll continue our partnership with Research Western. So these are the initiatives that John Capone and his team have brought forward. The SEED and the Bridge grants, these are two important ones. And so the SEED grants, many of you will be familiar with. These are applications that go forward to the Central University through Research Western. We are involved in adjudicating those. You'll be asked to come forward and do a presentation, a 5-minute presentation, and then some Q&A following that. And then a decision is made as to whether you would be awarded funding or not. If you're awarded funding, it'll be the amount of $25,000. Schulich automatically brings half of that funding to the table. So on those groups of grants, if you happen to receive one of those, for this year, we will also provide an additional $25,000 to bring that to a $50,000 level. So that's the kind of funding that will help you over the course of a year transition into that. Is it peer-reviewed? Yes. Is it a competition? Absolutely. But we have, as a school, fared very well at that level. We will also take grants that scored very highly in that competition and were not eligible for that split funding simply because there wasn't enough funding to do that, and we will provide additional funding to $25,000 to as many as we possibly can. The second is that we're going to introduce a new series of grants, and these are $100,000 grants. And very specifically, these grants are meant for teams. So that we can work with you to ensure that your team continues to function over this interval of time. So we want to ensure, though, that these are groups of individuals who have already demonstrated that they're working together, and that an infusion of funding of this magnitude will carry them over the course of the next year and allow them to get ready for the next series of major Tri-Council grants. You'll also see introduced in the course of this year funding that will go specifically to help with small equipment. So if you're looking about your lab and you've been complaining about the centrifuge that keeps breaking down, or you need to replace a rotor, because those are going to be $20,000 to $25,000 a pop, this is the sort of thing for you to be applying to. Again, there will be some peer review to it. Those guidelines will be coming to you very, very quickly on that front. We also have the Dean's competition in the summer, which is a $500,000 competition. And those funds are really driven by the clinical side of our shop. Those are grants that are meant to be addressing the strategic initiatives of the school, demonstrate that there's collaboration between different aspects of the faculty, so not only within individual clinical departments, but across into the basic sciences departments. These grants are on average anywhere from $150,000 to $300,000 over a 3-year time period, and we've had $500,000 grants that we've awarded out of all of that. For those of you that are writing grants and getting ready for the March competition for CIHR, I strongly urge that you contact Denise Figelwitz's office to have assistance with internal reviewing of your grants before they go out. Increasingly, we are seeing that our success rates are maintained for those grants where there's a rigorous internal review before the grants get submitted so that we can catch all of those errors that none of us see. So there are a lot of programs that are coming forward that you will see are in place. We're going to continue them, and new ones that we've added on. all of these programs are really meant to try and address all the individual pieces of this puzzle. We will be continuing over the course of this year to keep a really close eye on this. It's an absolute priority for me, having made all of this investment into our faculty, into all of our infrastructure. This is an opportunity for us during a time of significant national change on the funding milieu to ensure that we continue to drive our investigators forward with whatever assistance that we can provide. And so today's sampling for you is a bit of all of that. It really is meant to try and see if we can help.